What's up guys, Ben here from AuthenTech, and today we're checking out the S5 robot vacuum from Roborock. Now I previously reviewed the Xiaomi Mi Vac, and that thing was fantastic. The manufacturer of that robot vac was actually Roborock, so now they're back with an upgraded new and improved model. This is their S5 and it has some great new features. Now starting out, in the box includes the S5 robot vac, spare filter, charging dock with waterproof landing pad, a water bank, and two mopping cloths. I love the clean and modern white design. Under the flap is the dustbin and a very clever new spot to clip in the cleaning tool. This way you don't lose it, and it's always right where you need it to comb out hair and debris. Setup is a cinch, simply plug in the dock and fully charge the vacuum, download their Mi Home app, add new device, it auto found mine, connect it to your home Wi-Fi and it automatically updates, that's it. In the app, there's a ton of settings to tinker with, which I always appreciate. For example, there's volume settings, carpet auto boost suction mode, timer for scheduled cleanups, firmware updates, even a remote control joystick to drive your vac around, if only I had a cat. You can also set the vacuum suction strength or turn on mopping mode, which is one of its new key features. Basically, the S5 is kind of like a robot vac and wet mop built into one. There's this water tank, easy to fill, that clicks into the bottom of the vac with a microfiber cloth that's securely Velcroed on. So not only is it vacuuming and sweeping up your house, but it can double its capabilities with mopping your floor. It's very cool. Now you'll have to make sure it doesn't run on your carpet. So in the settings, there's this toggle for mopping mode. Unfortunately, mine seems to have a bug and wouldn't let me through, even though it says I'm running the latest firmware. However, easily I set up custom zones, drew digital boundaries for only my hardwood floor areas, hit go, and easy peasy. It seems to leave behind a nice streak of moisture and it overlaps well. The little water canister lasted about 45 minutes, then needed a refill. I wish it had a sensor to notify me in the app when this runs empty. Sadly, it does not. At the end of the cleaning, the microfiber cloth was plenty dirty, which on one hand makes me feel good, like it was doing a good job mopping my floors. But then on the other hand, I don't know how much it's actually picking up, or maybe is it just spreading the dirt around? I guess it's kind of like having a Swiffer wet jet tailing behind. It's nice to have the option. So the biggest feature on the first gen Mi Vac was its smart mapping technology. It uses lasers and sensors to intelligently route and navigate throughout my entire home. And it generates a real-time map on my phone. And if it runs low on battery, it'll auto dock, recharge, and then resume its cleanup where it left off. Super impressive. Well, this new S5 updated model not only does all that, but comes back with some even cooler features built on top. Now, actually kind of funny, back in my first Mi Vac review, I requested, but instead this could be accomplished with simple blocking out areas on the digital map that the Mi Vac creates. Let me draw on the map, digital borders where it should and shouldn't clean. Let's all just pretend they actually heard my request and implemented it. Now you can create custom zones for specific cleaning areas. It's as easy as drawing squares on your floor plan, and you can even tell it to clean up 1, 2, or 3 times, then hit go. It'll auto navigate to that area and run a full cleaning. Those vacuum lines are just so beautiful. I think I have an unhealthy obsession to seeing those every morning when I walk into my office. It's kind of like having a personal maid with free unlimited cleanups. Another cool mapping feature, you can simply tap anywhere on the map and the robot vac will zoom right there. From that point, you can then tell it to start a spot cleanup that's clever and convenient for those targeted cleaning areas. Feature request, how cool would it be to schedule cleanups for specific areas at specific times? For example, every night after dinner, head to the kitchen or dinner table and then run a spot cleanup. That'd be awesome. Currently and thankfully, if I'm not super lazy, I can still do that with just a couple taps. As for a few other key specs, it has a 5200 milliamp hours battery, which is rated to give you 2.5 hours of cleaning on a single charge. It has strong suction power for cleaning up all sorts of debris, plus side brush to pull in outside dust and dirt. The air filter can be rinsed underwater for easy cleaning. There's cliff sensors to protect the vac from rolling over the edge. It can cross over obstacles of 2 centimeters in height. And on this note, I actually saw it roll up and over a bathroom rug that the older model always got hung up on. This is cool to see. You can always purchase magnetic tape separately to mark off boundaries around certain objects you want the S5 to work around. Maybe you don't want the vac to venture under the bed or run into the Christmas tree. Now for my wishlist items, I still have a few. As smart as the robot vac is, it's not perfect and can still get stuck on certain objects. As a pro tip, I normally recommend running a quick pickup of items throughout your home. This allows the vac to clean every inch possible with efficiency and less hiccups. Secondly, I wish the vac nozzle and roller was a bit wider. Just compare it to a normal size vacuum and you can see the difference. I bet in the future as batteries get better, we'll see more width added. Also, why not add a second side brush to push in even more debris directly into the path of the center vac? This just makes sense, right? And lastly, number 3, even though I like the rubber flaps on the roller, it still often gets wrapped up with hairs and strings, which yes, the cleaning tool helps clean out, but I kinda like the tangle-free rollers like on this design. It never gets tangled up with hairs. Maybe Roborock can borrow this design in a future model? Now in conclusion, for cleaning capabilities and smart nav, the S5 is top of the line. As for pricing, it's currently listed at $579. Now I wish that was a bit more affordable, maybe more in the $300 to $350 range. However, I still say with its laser mapping technology and app features, it's still better and cheaper than other pro models out there. So I guess this price is semi-fair when comparing to the top competition. Plus, it's available on Amazon Prime with free 2-day shipping for us Prime members. I always love that. As always, all the links will be down in the description. If you enjoyed this video, leave me a comment right below that thumbs up. Huge thanks to Roborock for sponsoring this video. And if you're new around here, hit subscribe and ring the bell to stay up to date on all my future tech videos. Until next time, let's live authentic.